Okay. Hi guys, this is Grace again for another monthly reading. So this might be a bit late, but still a few days before 1st of November, so still relevant when I was when I'm recording this reading. So I have three cards here. Firstly, I want to talk about this month or the current energy right now. As I'm recording this, I'm still feeling the energy of new moon in Scorpio, and it's bringing a lot of deep feelings within me. It's kind of hard, especially I have my moon in Scorpio too. I don't know if you're feeling those energies too, but yeah. I was thinking it might probably just my hormones too, but it is the energy. I did feel like crying. So if you feel like crying, if you're feeling deep emotions, especially those emotions that you haven't purged within you, let it purge, let it out. I always say face your shadows, so which means, but I've never really explained it properly, which means facing all those, it's including facing all those deep emotional pain or wounding that you've had, and it feels hard because it feels like you are reliving the memories again, but it's something that you need to face and not run away from. And once you face it and you purge it, you will feel a lot better. You just gotta release it. And I thought, you know, should I cry now or should I do something else? I thought I'll just do this reading and I'll face those emotions later. I don't know, I think I'm kinda running away from it too, but I'm just thinking, if I don't do this right now, I'm not gonna feel productive and I'm gonna feel really bad and really sad, more sad than I should be feeling. So yeah, but if you feel like, if you've always worked and you've always been productive, in this today, this will resonate for some of you today. You might just be feeling like really bad and don't want to do anything. Let yourself do that, okay? If you've always been productive and just for today, you've got to rest, do some self-care, and it's okay, okay? It's okay. I'm saying to myself, because I can be quite workaholic sometimes, so for some of you, you might also be. So don't measure every day because don't measure your day, don't always measure your day based on how productive you are. Measure it based on how present you are. Measure it based on your presence. So that's just a message for someone if you're still listening. But here are my three cards. So someone said I should show it. I forgot to show this from my previous video, the options better. So this is for number one, this is for number two, this is for number three, and I always timestamp this. So just if you haven't seen it and you're too early on my videos, just refresh it and you will see that I've timestamped it. And sometimes I forgot to pin it. So just look around on the comment section. it's there, okay? Because some people are like, where's the timestamp? And yeah. Okay. Right. I'll start. So for people who picked this card number one, I'll get onto your reading. This one here. We'll see the theme of the month. Theme of the month for you is strength. Keep going, be strong. That's the message that I'm getting from this card. Strength, I always see this card as healing, especially from the tarot card. Reminds me of the tarot card strength. Because it's orange, it could be something to do with healing the sacral chakra. That this is where all the intimacy issues, the trust issues that we have. So most likely the theme of the month is all about healing those and facing those. So you'll encounter things where you have to be tested based on trusting people in your partnerships. So yeah, I'm sensing someone being paranoid with trust here. But this is like, I'm hearing that you will encounter, this is encountering silent battles. So the silent battles that no one knows you're battling with, this is what this is all about. So be strong, keep going. You are hereby declared a strong, resilient warrior of heroic proportions. Enjoy your battles, whatever they are, because you're guaranteed to come through them stronger, brighter, and more compassionate. Don't let those bad times, all those things that bad things that happen to you, don't let it harden your heart. Okay? That's how you win your battles, by not letting it get into you, but not letting it harden you. And based on what I know of mythology, probably with a great hair and a six pack. So yeah, your strength is what makes you more attractive. Your strength, you and you are as a person. It's perfect because I've got this as the orange also with the sacral chakra, so it's perfect. Because I'm just getting, like, for some people this could just be something to do with self-doubt and insecurities. So yeah, self-acceptance also. So let's see what's coming in love for you, whether you're single or you're in a connection or in a relationship. Let's see what's coming in love for you. One more. I feel like the energy is very strong, and I can connect better with the messages. It's probably the season. Okay, I'll take it. Right. Go, 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 energy. Rest. This is very tiring. I don't know why I'm getting very tiring energy. This is the end of a cycle. So first, if you're single and maybe looking for love, or not looking for love, just if you're single, I see here, this is about judgment is about ending of a cycle here. And um, I'm getting this is like hatred with the Knight of Swords here. Like having like a confrontation with someone. And it's like you got a rest. You've always battled it, but now you've got a rest from all the drama. Like you need to this time to be on your own, rest from all the drama, and focus on yourself. There might be someone that is trying to get your attention or still devoted to you, and you're just still thinking whether it's worth it to pursue that. Okay. For some of you, you might probably be the one that is like been devoted to someone, and even though their things did not end well with this person, but I feel like the cycle is ending anyway. You've probably been always devoted to someone, and now it's time for you to focus on yourself and rest. If you're in a relationship, I feel like your connection is maturing at the next level. I'm getting here much maturation. So, you know, ending something and taking it to the next level. Okay, so this could mean different things for different people. I'm getting also here with the judgment. This could be the connection somehow ended, and now this is a renewal. So whether you're in a connection with someone or you are already in a relationship with someone, that's what I'm getting here. It's not the time to be impulsive with words. I feel like you both need to work on intimacy. Someone might be giving more than the other. Okay. In this relationship. So, let's see in career what is coming for you. Career. Those are already three cards. I could have taken it, but okay. Swords in reverse. Wheel of Fortune in reverse. Okay. Career. I just remembered someone telling me it's all reverse because I've put it that way. Like, reverse cards are not always bad. Like, oh well. Like, what's the problem? So, career. Self-expression is needed here with the Queen of Swords. I don't know if you're not entirely honest towards your across your career, whatever you're doing, or you're just not expressing yourself. Maybe you just need to express yourself more. It's not that you're not being honest, but maybe for some of you, you're not being honest with yourself too. But I'm sensing here that there is still some lesson that needs to be learned with the Wheel of Fortune in reverse. You might want to get ahead and really, you know, push forward and get to the next step of your journey. But there are some lessons that you still haven't learned. So it feels like you're going back instead of going forward. Okay? With the Wheel of Fortune in reverse. There are some things that you might have missed. There are some key things. So it's like there's a blockage here for you moving forward. But I'm sensing here with the Nine of Swords in reverse, it's more positive because it's the reverse meaning of what I'm getting here. The reverse meaning of the Nine of Swords, which is all about anxiety, all about you cannot think straight, you cannot sleep. I don't know why I got debts, but debts. Thinking how to pay off debts. But if this could be someone like a boss or something with the Queen of Swords in reverse, being very critical towards you, but it could be just you actually being critical towards yourself. Don't mind them. Don't mind those negative thoughts. Part of loving yourself is affirming every single time that negative thoughts arise, affirming to yourself, affirming and changing those negatives into positive, trying to fight it in a way. That's part of loving yourself. I feel like I'm extra slow today, but I'm gonna do it slow because that's the vibe that I'm getting. What else? I think that's all that I'm getting with the career. So don't react so much if you feel like you're not getting anywhere in your life, in your career at the moment. It's happening for a reason. As I said, there are some things that you might have overlooked. And assert yourself. Don't be aggressive, but don't be passive. Just assert yourself. Say what you want to say and mean what you want to say. Mean what you say and say what you mean. Now, in terms of where you're currently at in your energy right now, where's your energy currently right now when you're watching this reading? So if this resonates, this is really for you. I mean, if you're still watching, this is probably for this is probably resonating in a way. Let's see. Current energy for right now. And your energy, where will you be in the month of November? Cutting away illusion. Yeah. Yeah. I'm just getting here, like, especially when it comes to career, but also we have here the Knight of Swords, so not only in the aspect of career. I don't know why I got career first, but also in the aspect of love, there's this cutting away illusion that will happen. Don't know, I feel like you're gonna be more in a mind space that is more rational. Maybe you've always used your heart, maybe you've always followed your emotions in a way that, I mean, I always say follow your emotions, follow your heart, but that should be balanced with your mind. Okay, sometimes when we go too much into our emotions, we start to romanticize things, romanticize our love, what has happened to us, and we start to overlook some things and become more tolerant to people, even though, like when we start to be more tolerant, we start to not see their bad behavior or bad intentions. Okay, so yeah, when it comes to career and love, cutting away illusion, you will see the truth of what it is and what's really happening here. Wide open. The possibilities are wide open. For some of you, meeting another person, if you're open to that, I mean, it's saying here, be open to that, but if you're open to that, that is possible to happen. If you're stagnant and really stagnant in your career, if it's not really for some of you, it's really something that you really want to do. For some of you, it's not really something that you want to do. So spirit is saying, you will cut away the illusion in this month and see that there are other possibilities. There are other things that you can do other than the things that you're trying to endure and have always been struggled with. Okay, it's like I'm saying here, it's like saying it's an illusion thinking that something is that if that it, that it's only an illusion if you think, oh, if I lose this job, I'm gonna be like in more into debt, in poverty, or it's like the end of the world or something. So that's what I'm getting. Now, in terms of where you're currently at in your energy, we have here mother and daughter. Mothering, teaching, sharing knowledge, nurturing self-worth. Yeah. As I was saying, nurturing self-worth. I feel like you must continue in that anyway. Sometimes it might have stemmed from your mother or your connection with your mother. Most of the things of what we're going through right now have stemmed from our childhood and our own upbringing. And now that we're adults, if there are some unhealthy behaviors, it's time to change that. It's reparenting ourselves. So we cannot blame this anymore from the parents of how you are as a person and how it has affected your own self-worth. So self-worth here, the Hanged Man. I'm getting here, you're standing in your two feet. You're now standing in your 2 feet. And you're wiser and better. You're gaining a lot of wisdom. You've already gained a lot of wisdom from your experiences. So use that wisdom. You've transformed. You've changed a lot. Now use although there are still some lessons that you're meant to learn, you've already transformed and you've been through a lot. And Now it's time for this journey. The possibilities are wide open. Now this you're transitioning into this month, cutting away illusions. You're more grounded now than ever. Okay? That's what I'm getting here. Now, the environment. Let's see how the environment will be. How it might affect you in this month of November. Risk. Now there will be people that are so afraid of risks and might tell you you're being crazy when you're trying to maybe leave a relationship, leave a job, do something crazy, do something really new. Okay, I feel like there will be these people who are not very supportive of that, or maybe they're just being protective of you. They might think your ideas are not gonna are not I'm not real, okay? But I'm seeing here, you're seeing clearly, you're cutting away illusions, so take those risks anyway, even if people might try to prevent you based on their, because they care about you, or even though those people are like in this mentality of fear-based mentality. That's just what I'm getting. So, what's the advice for you in this month? Let's see. Be open. Twice, we have here the open. Discard and discard. Be open to a communication from an unexpected place. So be open. I feel like this is about, could be your guides, ancestors, your spirit guides. Be open to the messages that you're getting from spirit. It sort of feels like she entered a new, like a portal. The High Priestess from the land of Ariani. Wonder what it says on the book. Yeah, starting a new beginning on something with the one there. Listen carefully for answers and directions from the inner earth and star beings. They may have an assignment for you or something to share. Heart chakra healing. As much as the sacral chakra here. Heart chakra healing. Pay attention to that. So heart chakra is all about forgiveness. Going towards your passion, trying to have emotional balance, not giving from an empty cup, compassion. Yeah, you will come out of this stronger and compassionate, as this card says. So, heart chakra is all about learning compassion and having real and true connections with others. Okay, and that's it's connected to this in a way that the intimacy and the trust has to be built too. So, what else? Surrender to the wonder and awe. Open to the magic of every moment and sense the awe and wonder in all of life. This attitude will keep you connected to the ecstasy of flow. So, as I said from the beginning of this reading, this is balancing the light and the dark. Especially this season right now. starting from the Scorpio new moon that just happened. This is facing our shadow self. You could re-listen to the intro of the reading if you haven't listened to that, but I've talked about how and what facing your shadow self is about. So let me know how this resonated for you, what kind of readings you want to see next, and I'm sending you love and light. So for people who picked card number 2 or this is your reading. Oh, it's blue too. Oh gosh, like the number 1, it's both orange. Anyway, good things to come. Wow, good energy. I'm also getting third eye chakra. As much as blues can also be about this throat chakra, maybe both, but good things to come. There are so many amazing gifts coming my way. I can't see them now because I respect the general convention of not peeking under wrapping paper. But they will show up when the time is just right, and that's when I'll remember how much fun is it to be surprised. Interesting. Lots of surprises is the theme for the month of November for you. So there'll be a lot of surprises. There'll be a lot of amazing gifts coming. Interesting. Really, really, really good. Okay, I'm really feeling really good. The energy. So let's see what's coming for you in terms of love. King of Swords. Right. What else? Ace of Wands in reverse. In the Seven of Pentacles. I feel like if you're single or you're looking, waiting for someone, waiting to connect with someone, someone's possibly coming back with more integrity and honesty. They might try to just communicate with you and it's not something new, especially with the Ace of Wands in reverse. I'm getting the waiting is over and someone's coming with honesty. Okay, don't be like too excited into this, but I mean, be excited, but just getting here, be excited but be calm. I don't know how you do that, but it could just be like a conversation. Like, it doesn't have to be, it's not like this person's gonna propose to you. Like, that's not what I'm getting here. It could just be an honesty and a conversation, and someone is trying to be more, in their integrity. Okay, trying to explain something, you know that. But I'm not really saying that might not happen, that the proposal and all that, but it might not be that. Okay. For some of you, it might be, but it might not be that. So really good. I feel like when this person comes, it's okay for you to trust them because they're being honest. Now, if you're in a relationship, I'm getting here a return of investment. I don't know why I'm getting like trust again with this card. Like, maybe it's a whole theme of the month for all of us. like all about the intimacy in the trust issues and the sacral chakra. But that's what I'm getting here, like do something about that to for you to be able to connect better with your person in that intimacy area. Not just sexual, physical, but also could be that, but also, as I said, connecting with the person on a deeper level, on a soul level, having the, you know, starting from having that deep conversations, really opening up with someone. That's what I'm getting, and that will really enrich your connection. I feel like someone will give you, is giving you a gift, like your partner is planning to give you a gift if you're in a relationship already. But I'm just getting here, it's just in terms of like people that are in a relationship, there's not really much problem. I'm getting here, it's more positive in. If there's are any issues, you know, work on this trust and intimacy and just basically communicate. Now let's see on career, based what's going to happen based on career. Hermit. I'm getting like for some of you, you might be going solo, so maybe you're coming from a company or a partnership and now trying to go solo. Maybe it's a business or your own career, opening up your own office. Your own private practice. So, Page of Pentacles and the Sun. Really good, really positive. Like, whether it's love and career, it's really positive for the peoples who pick this card number two. I mean, starting with the good things to come. So, the Sun is a really positive card. Go with the flow of your ideas and it will lead you to your happiness. Okay? If you feel like you need to go on your own journey right now, be solo in your adventure, do that. Don't forget to play. Okay? Don't forget to play. But I'm getting like, if for a while you might need to take a vacation or something and rest, do that. Take this time, maybe even for just a day, to really think about your future and what you really want to happen in your life. And it will allow you to tap into these ideas, these concrete ideas that you can start, and that will lead you to this happiness in the future. I mean, I'm not saying that the happiness is not something that you will not feel right now. For you to not be able to miss that happiness, it's about all about living in the present and being playful and being not too serious about things, looking at your career through the eyes of a child, and enjoy it. As I said, I don't know if you follow me on my Instagram, but I said something about do something you enjoy or enjoy what you do. Because if you, I was talking about succeeding and failing. So, enjoy what you do or do something that you enjoy. Because if you do something that you enjoy and you succeed on it, it's a win-win situation. And if you did something that you enjoy but you failed, at least you've enjoyed. Like, it's still kind of worth it in a way. And if you're doing something that you don't enjoy, but you succeed on it, I mean, I guess it's good, okay? But what if you did something that you don't enjoy and you did not succeed on it and you failed? You just be end up miserable. So do something that you enjoy or enjoy what you're doing. Okay. So I thought I'm not going to be able to talk about that in the reading, but it seems like that's what I need to talk about now. So love, career, where are you currently at right now in your life? In current energy right now? I'll take that, I got two. In where are you current energy right now? Clarified by... Queen of Pentacles. So, okay. I always see this card as the Hermit. With all the wisdom. Especially we have your like ancestors, ancestral line, generational relational shift. Your ancestors might be trying to communicate with you, especially, you know, it's the season. It's the season for this. Coming from Halloween season, ancestors, but we also have here the Unicorn and the Maiden. This is about being yourself, being true to yourself, embodying who you are. This is about talking about being yourself. It's all about doing things because you want to do it and not caring about what other people may think of you and not doubting yourself. And that's how you empower yourself. Being yourself is like not doing things because other people told you so, doing things because you feel like you want to do it. Okay. We have your Queen of Pentacles. Nurturing yourself. And your own self-worth. I'm also getting to. Something to do with self-worth. I got that from one too, so. But this is something to do with maybe you're nurturing other people, being balanced, being able to be, maybe this is your goal, being self-sufficient and giving, being able to give to others too, having that spare to be able to give to others. Being grounded, being that badass I'm getting. So let's see what this is about. So get it to read it from the book. So see what is the light. Light the darkness. Well, from in the intro of the reading, I talked about the general message, talking about the facing your darkness. So you could re-listen to that if you haven't listened to it and you skipped on that, if you want to. So light the darkness in reverse. Saying here, the current energy right now, only speaking to people your own age, knowing little about your older relatives, mistrusting people who are older, stereotypical thinking and beliefs about older people, needing to connect with the other older people but feeling cut off from them, feeling they are unlike you. believing the generation gap is too wide to be bridged or that bloodlines don't matter. Denying your DNA, as I said, denying who you truly are. Wanting to cut yourself off from your family or of origin and their history and traditions. I mean, if they're like toxic kind of family and it's all really, really disrespecting you, that might be valid. Like, I don't blame you for that if you want to cut yourself off from the tradition and the family, if that doesn't make sense to you. But this card is more talking about honoring your from where you came from and who you are. Okay, it's part of knowing yourself, like tracing your roots. Okay, because whether you like it or not, it's part of you. That's where you came from. So this is about connecting back to your roots. I'm getting also, maybe you want a cut off, like you don't understand your family, you don't understand the older people. This is saying that you could learn something from them. There might just be a misunderstanding. You cannot just brush off something that is like avoid something just because you don't know anything about it. Sometimes we try to just avoid things that, and we call things, we call people crazy or call the things crazy. You know, the reason why people call something crazy, it's just their way of rationalizing things because they don't understand them. But what I'm getting here, if you don't understand something, why not do something to make yourself understand? Sometimes it's all about, all the misunderstanding is all about your, it's all about, it stems from ignorance, not knowing more about the issue. So maybe it's just saying the current energy is like connecting to that, connecting to your roots, and maybe researching about your origins, connecting with ancestors through that way. And then we have your 10 in reverse, the unicorn and the maiden in reverse. The unicorn is a symbol of ancient magics rising in purification of the earth. So we have here misunderstanding again. As I was talking about misunderstanding, we have here misunderstanding. Misunderstanding and underestimating your own power to bring about peaceful solutions to a difficult challenge. Feeling alone and unsafe, unsure of whether your visions are authentic. Feeling deluded and confused by visions and psychic communications. Feeling haunted and as though you must hide away to be yourself and to be safe. Okay? Your third eye chakra might be too open. Especially with all the eyes here. And when that happens, it's just like you get a lot of psychic information and it might be too much for you, and which is causing, maybe you're getting messages from your ancestors and it's causing confusion in you, and you're starting to doubt where those messages are coming from. I feel like the advice here is to try to eat healthier, at least for right now. Try to at least eat more healthy foods and organic food, knowing where your food is coming from. Yeah, because I'm also getting here headaches. So I don't know how is that resonating with your current energy right now, but that's what I'm getting. Now, where will you be? Your energy. What your energy will be in the month of November. So I have here this Tarot of Transformation. Get one card for this. Okay. The Magician. Master of Conscious Creation. With Wishing Well. Wow. I feel like whatever you manifested, it's coming. It's coming back to you. Like, if this is not Wishing Well, dude, I might have read it a bit more negatively. Like, you need to work on your manifesting abilities. But it could just be saying, keep your vibration high and your energy high. Anyway, it could be something to do with, like, you know, we don't always think about this, but food and what we eat, it affects us. It affects how we think, it affects our brain, it affects our emotions. So, as I was saying, with the eating healthy here, but it also affects your vibration. Okay, high vibrational food, you feel more energy, you feel more fresh and all that, you know. But keeping your energy, your vibrational energy high, and you're on your way to this. Your wishes coming true. Okay? You're really attracting things. Okay? So if your vibration is not high, you might quickly attract bad things. If you're expecting that. And if your mindset is more on the negative. Okay, so be careful what you wish for, because you might just get it during this month. There are good things to come. Really, really good. Okay. Let's see what else is the Wishing Well saying. Good, good. Desire is a sacred impulse for life. Feel it, but let go of all attachment to ownership. So, when it comes to manifestation, I was talking about my best friend yesterday about this. Like, because I did a vision board. So, maybe doing a vision board will help you. It still works, especially with the current new moon right now, as I'm reading this. But the more energy, the more effort that you put onto something, it's like doing a spell. The more effort you do and energy you do on something, the more it works. And I know I've written something before, like an affirmation of how I want to live my life, like 5 years ago. And now 5 years later, I saw my journal again, and I looked at my journal, and I read what I've written. I've completely forgotten about this, what I've written, but now I'm currently living my life. I'm currently living the life that I want to live, in that, like, whatever I've written, I'm trying to say, whatever I've written in my journal, like, I want to live my life. I want to be in service to other people, and now I'm doing readings, being in service to you, to other people. So it works. Maybe writing down something, you know, it works. I feel like it works better if you forget about it. Forget that you actually write down something. I feel like that's what letting go of all the ownership and then the attachment. Because when you're too attached on the results, I feel like you prevent it more from coming. So it's saying here, feel it, but let go of all the attachment to ownership. So don't be attached to the results. Okay, like always thinking about this. Okay, always thinking about, oh, will it happen? Will it happen? Continue living your life. Like, when you've written it, let it go. Continue living your life. Desire is the most important impulse for creating life. Now you're seeing the relationship between desire and inspiration and sensing that moment of truth when you feel the inception of new life. It is an aha moment when everything makes sense. Okay, perhaps you recognize a soulmate. A soulmate might come into your life. I mean, who knows? Good things to come. This can be anything. This is, we can be conceiving a baby, especially with the sun here, but this is more about the career. So conceiving an idea could be. Okay, the wishing well card awakens you to the presence of unseen forces that enable new beginnings. So the divine will be on you on this. So what is the advice for you in this month? We have here reverse again. Remember to ask the right question in reverse. Surrender to effortlessness. Surrender to prayer. I feel like the prayer and the asking is done already. Or if you're not asking anything to the universe, time to do that. But if you've already done that, you've already prayed, you've already asked for what you want, let it go. Now it's time for surrender to offer effortlessness. Stop pushing so hard. The art of living means going with the flow instead of trying to force the river. Okay. You know, if you wish on which, if you've already hoped and wish on something, it's on the works now. Okay, so don't worry about it so much. But this could also be saying, remember to ask the right question in a way that is what you're wishing for is actually what your heart's true desire. Because if it's not aligning to what your heart's true desire, it might not happen. Okay, sometimes what we want is not what we need. So, and what's our true heart's desire if we're not connected to it? We thought we want something, but then, you know, that something didn't come, but then something better comes to us. Something's more aligned to our heart's true desires, you know. Sometimes maybe you're wishing and you're trying to settle for less, okay? You're wishing for a really small thing when you deserve so much better, okay? Don't be afraid to wish. When you wish, be bigger about it. Like, wish something bigger, okay? That makes sense. Then we have your emotional balance in reverse. I mean, we both have here the cup being in an upright, I mean, being in the reverse position. When I see that, it reminds me of the Ace of Cups in your connection to spirit. So connect more with spirit. Be in harmony with the spirit, the light and the dark. Especially with this card, your light in the darkness. Balancing your lights, your shadow self, in your when you're positive. Because sometimes we're focused so much on the positive, okay? And with the shadow self, I'm talking about the things that facing your shadows, facing the things that you feel shameful about yourself. But I also feeling here just, you know, surrender to with the flow, surrender to effortlessness, and surrender to peace, okay? Finding peace, surrender to balance and harmony, and especially emotional balance. Because when you're emotionally balanced, that will help you really align and be in a higher vibration to what you're wishing for and what you want. Okay. That's what I'm getting. So that is your reading. Let me know how this resonated in the comments. If you want personal readings, my email is in the description box. And I'm sending you love and light. Thank you for watching. So for people who picked this card number 3 or this, this is your reading. So what's the theme of your month of November? We have your impermanence, but actually gotten this card reverse. There might not be a lot of changes in your life, you know. I feel like whatever is happening in your October, or especially in the last weeks of October, will keep happening through the months of November. Whether it's you think it's a good thing that is happening in your life or not. But for some of you, this could be about being open to changes. Okay, it might be the exact opposite, like the other end. You know, it's either there might not be a lot of changes. You might still be going through what you're going through, or there might be big changes and you should not resist them. But the main message here, whether there will be changes or not, a lot of changes, is about not letting what's happening on the outside and in your environment affect you and your mood and affect who you are as a person. Okay? You are the sky, and these things that are happening in your life are like the clouds. The clouds are passing, even though the storm, even though there are storms. Okay, remember, you are the sky, so you are still in control, even if you don't feel that you do, even if you don't feel that you are not in control. Life is always changing, and I drift easily through those changes, good and bad. As I drift through hard times, I can take comfort in knowing that I will leave them behind. As I drift away from good times, I can take comfort in knowing that more will come my way. Impermanence is an equal opportunity, not entity. So, let's see. What will happen to you? What's likely to happen to you in terms of love? Whether you're single, in a connection, in a relationship. Page of Pentacles in reverse. The Hermit in reverse. Okay. And the Two of Cups. Yeah. If you're single, it's the time to be in love. Or you will build connection and successful friendships with other people. This doesn't have to mean right away soulmate, romantic relationship, but it could be. I'm getting here, you won't feel alone anymore, you won't be alone anymore, you will find someone who you connect with. A soulmate, could be a friendship, could be someone more than a friendship. But it's a really good connection. Okay, someone that you can share your thoughts with, you can talk to with. Okay, someone that you can possibly build with. You know, you just... It's flowing. It's a flowing connection. It feels safe. It feels like you understand each other. If you're meeting someone that is it's very similar to you and your beliefs, and it's very comforting. Okay? So, that's what I'm getting. If you're in a connection, deepening of love. If you're in a relationship, this could be deepening of love. There might be some things that is not working out. Maybe you planned something and didn't work out. But I feel like in those cases, you might just need to give space towards each other. And all is well. And after that, all will be well. Okay? If you're feeling angry about something, if about your own personal issue, don't take it out on your partner. It's not helpful. Have that alone time. I'm also getting here coming back. So if you're maybe in a separation or waiting on someone, trying to connect with someone, there's this like feeling of like coming back, whether it's a physical or coming back of feelings. And it's something that is mutual that I'm getting. But if you're in a connection, if you're in a relationship right now, in a partnership, it's a safe partnership. You have nothing to really worry about. Okay. I'm just getting here. Sometimes you must create distance in a way that you need to have your alone time too. Okay. So, what's happening in your career? Of swords in reverse. Knight of Pentacles. And Nine of Pentacles. Really good. It's quite good. You might be receiving some offers. Career-related offers. Okay, if you're having a project or something, presenting something, you will be well received. If you're starting a new job, when you doesn't have to be starting a new job, but for some of you, it will be. You will be well received. There will be. I'm getting your recognition. And you will have a lot of, I feel like career will be good for you. Like, it's something that you've been waiting for. Like, you're getting out of the darkness, and you've always wanted to get out of the darkness, and you've struggled. You've worked hard for this. All this, anxiety, all this, like, mental strain is being paid off. And you will get a lot of rewards. Getting could be monetary and tangible rewards, okay, in your career. It's really good. Okay, maybe someone offering you from maybe from another company, or there'll be offers. Okay. Because they're recognizing your talent and your abilities. Maybe a better pay from trying to give you a better offer, a better pay. Trying to make you come into their company. I don't know, that's what I'm getting. but you'll be well sought after. Generally positive I'm getting with your career. I feel like that's all I'm getting. Let's see in terms of where are you currently at in your energy right now? Okay, I'll get that. Stardust in reverse. We have your premonition, galactic communications, beginnings and endings. I feel like pay attention to your dreams. That's what I'm getting with this. And we have the Merlin, guidance, mentorship, teacher of the old ways. Okay. Maybe you've been through a lot and you've learned something from whatever has happened to you. It's time to share your gifts. It's time to maybe because of this, you'll be given an opportunity to do this. It's time to share your knowledge and your gifts to others and give back. That's the current energy here. What else is this about? The Hermit. Wow, we have here the Hermit again. Now it's upright position. I mean, the Merlin is like the Hermit to me also in this card. So you coming out, I feel like this is instead of like going within, this is about you're coming out of that going within. Okay, you're coming out of that. Maybe you've been introverted or you've been on your own for quite some time and you're coming out of that. It's time to integrate yourself back with society, community, and teach. Okay? Or lead people. Let's see what is this about in the book. Stardust in reverse, 35. When this card comes forward to greet you, it may be a time when someone is passing and a time when something new will be born from this passing. You may be refusing to acknowledge this or unaware of someone's changing life and times, denying feelings that are deep within and that seem to forewarn and foreinform of future events. So you might be getting something, a premonition about something to do with impermanence here, as I'm saying, don't resist the changes. And you're feeling that there might be changes. You might still be trying to hold back to your comfort zone. Okay, you might be dismissing this. Especially, as I said, pay attention to your dreams. Maybe keep a journal. While you may be unable to sense what is going to happen before it does, you may still be wondering what to do with such a nebulous, delicate source of information. Because you do not know what to do, you too often deny it. And thus, events you could have avoided or let others know about come about. Okay? You might be dismissing these messages because you don't know what to do. But for some of you, if that doesn't resonate, it's just saying you might be out of touch of your precognizance or your own intuitive gifts. you might be also looking too closely for meaning or in too bright and busy a place. Okay, let the musing come in at night time and information will flow through more easily and clearly. Maybe through your I said through your dreams. I said it so many times already. Or when before you sleep, that's when you meditate, and that's where try to relax. That's where the information will come to you more easily. Okay. Because there might be a lot of things that you're doing, a lot of responsibilities, too busy. Okay. As Merlin is a bard, you may be drawn to remembering and telling stories and tales of your own life at this time. As he is a wizard, high magics will attract you. As he is a guide, you will find a mentor and become a mentor in your own time. As he is a keeper of natural laws, you will find you are living in tune with magical cycles, and you will begin to read and know the messages for a time with such clarity, and you may shock others, even yourself. Growing older need be no block to wisdom, for you will not grow feeble nor doddery. You will know what is wise and what is not, and the difference between what is worth your time, what is worth your time, and what is not, will shine out in sharp relief. Trust the guidance that you're getting. Okay. Yeah. You really are developing your gifts, or really need to connect with your gifts during this time. Not surprising for this season. Oh, okay. So this is the current energy right now. We'll see the energy where you will be in the month of November. Possibly more of like in the middle of the month of November. We have here the Sun in reverse. Don't force clarity if you're not able to find clarity or don't know what to do. Don't force it. They said try to just enjoy what you're doing. I think I've said that in the people pick card number 2. But we have your commitment in reverse. Commitment in reverse, what is this about? See? A true commitment is a responsibility of the heart, mind, body, and soul. This is a good time to make one. I'm getting here. As I said, there might be a lot of things happening in the background, okay? Could be chaos, could be chaotic too. And you might need to be busy. But I'm getting here. Don't lose focus. Don't lose focus in your commitments and what you've started and your purpose and what makes you feel happy and what keeps you in flow. The radiance of your own being, yourself. Don't lose yourself in all the chaos. Okay, you are the sky. Going back to that, you may be walking into a commitment or contract that you will later regret. Okay, because if you're not focused, you might be walking in a contract or a commitment that you will later regret. This isn't a good time to sign agreements or make any choice that would tie you up for a long period. So, if it's something to do with a career, you might get some offers, but you don't, maybe really, really think about it. It might not be the right, decide on it really fast. You don't need to decide right now. Okay. As it is saying here, it's not a good time to sign agreements. If you are in a relationship, you may not receive the commitment that you desire, but don't despair, for something much better awaits you. You're just dodging a bullet. Okay? I think for some of you that might resonate. Now is also the time for agreements to be broken. Remember that rejection is God's protection. What hurts you now leads to wisdom later. So, with the dodging the bullet there. Okay? It might not be always happy this entire month. Okay? There might be the challenges. I don't want to call it struggle. You can choose to struggle about this or not struggle about this. It's how you live your life. But there'll be challenges anyway, because of these changes that will result to growth. Keep going anyway, even though you don't know where you're going or you cannot find the clarity yet. You will get there. Let's see what is the environment will be, how this will affect you. There will be choices. There will be choices. Okay, and you might be persuaded into doing something, committing to something or someone. There'll be choices. Don't settle. Okay, don't settle for less. As I said, you don't need to make the decision right now. Don't rush things. If you feel like you'll never find another person and you stay with a certain person, that's not true. You will have choices. You will have other choices. So if it's something to do with love or a person, there'll be choices with the offers. As I said, as I saw there in the career. So what's the advice for you? What's the advice for you? I don't know why it is always reverse. As you see here, not all cards are reverse. But it's always reverse. And I'm getting a comforting presence is on the way. Yeah, you're not seeing this, but a comforting presence is on the way. Something that could be a soulmate, but doesn't have to be a romantic partner. We have here. So yeah, you're not alone on this. But you must surrender your ego and your need to always be right. Give others the gift of letting them be right. Be yielding, not rigid. This will help resolve conflicts and improve your relationships. Okay, surrender your need to always be right. Other people will always have this their different point of view from you. Doesn't mean you are right and they are wrong, or they are right and you are wrong. You're just seeing things from different perspectives. And we have your wheel in reverse. Expression, assertiveness, self-control, direction. Okay, keep going anyway. Don't look back at the past, especially the past mistakes, what has happened in the past, and don't look back so much in the future and what might happen. Stay in the present. Keep going anyway, and even though you don't know where you're going, you still, even though you don't know who you are, even though you don't know where you're going, you're still somewhere. Even if you don't know who you are, you're still someone. Okay, so stay in your own lane. That is your reading. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know how re it resonated for you. For personals, my email is in this description box. And I'm sending you love and light, and thank you so much for watching.